What's going on, guys? It is Wednesday, and it's been 2 days since the council had met. The people that were in charge of what's going to be happening with the New Jersey legislation for legalization and legalization of marijuana in the state of New Jersey. They met on Monday with a draft of the bill, and it was presented, and I guess they discussed it, kind of tried to work on some stuff and clear things up. They also introduced the 6 licenses that are going to be following each part of the cannabis industry. So every part of the industry is broken down into 6 classifications, and each of those classifications will have to file for a certain license. They talked about how many different minorities are going to be able to get X amount of percentage, which is going to be about 30% total for all of them. They're going to have access to making sure they're getting into the industry. They talked a lot about the business aspects of it, so it seems like they have their mindset on where they want to go and towards the actual industry, but the actual legalization of it, they kind of left a lot of gray areas out, and they kind of left a lot of things untouched. So, you know, I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing, but there were some articles that were put on the internet from the Asbury Park Press and a couple other people. It looks like I can't even find those anymore. They were altered. A lot of them were like steering towards that. A lot of activists were not happy with legislation that's being put in place. And even I myself, you know, even before anything was said, the morning of Monday, I had a lot on my mind. I'd made several videos, which I don't know. It was a lot of like just going nowhere, as most of my stuff is, but it was just derailing real bad. So I kind of just waited and kind of gathered my thoughts to think about what I wanted to say, because nothing really got said. Like, we had a draft, which I did find online, and even that I can't even find. But what they talked about on Monday, I guess they were hoping to vote and finish it, but it seems like they're coming back on Thursday to talk about more topics and maybe open up some areas, because the way it was left on Monday is like, if this goes the way it's going to go, it's really only going to benefit big business and big pharma. It's not like a social justice thing, or personal choice, or even about the medical patients. It's about a business at this point, what they have mustered up. So hopefully on Thursday, there's going to be a lot of change implemented in there, to cover some issues, because look, I think the cannabis industry is going to do good things for New Jersey. I think it's going to bring a lot of business, but I also think that it's going to open the doors to medical patients, which New Jersey's medical program, it's pretty crummy. I'm in it myself, and I could tell you that, like, even just the last 2 days since all this has happened, I checked my local dispensary, and by local, I mean very far away, and it seems like all the product is just, like, gone. So all the medicine is just currently very low at the moment. And, you know, it wasn't like that a month ago. So, you know, that worries me. Like, are we going to see this, you know, being a more scarce and harder to access medicine, because we're also going to have recreational and we're not going to have anything open yet, and dispensaries are going to try to keep up with the public? Like, where is the medical side going to be on this? How much are those people going to suffer? How much harder is it going to be to get our medicine? You know, we're already paying expensive renewal fees. Even to get in the program is costly itself. And it's very lengthy. It's not easy. You know, you can go to a pain management doctor and probably get yourself some pain pills a lot faster than you can actually get on a program that actually is very helpful, you know, with a ton of different conditions. But it's hard to do this as it is. So now you're going to make it even harder for the medical side of patients. And now on top of this, you're going to turn around and say, hey, not only are we going to make this harder for them, but your medicine is going to be, you know, even further stricter. Like, we're talking about legalization here. We're not talking about, you know, legalization for business. We're talking about legalization for everybody, for the people, for the community, for the state of New Jersey. You know, that's what I was hoping for. The other thing that really sucks about it is, you know, they're talking about how they want to do this for social justice, but the big issue here is, how are you going to tell people that you need hundreds of thousands of dollars to operate these businesses? And, you know, there's not going to be really loans, because the cannabis is such a weird lucrative business as it is, that you're not going to be able to turn around and just, you know, say, hey, I got released from prison for, you know, cultivation or distributing on the black market, and now I'm going to be able to just jump into the industry and say, well, I can get a business license or a cultivation license. And, you know, I have these funds available because if you've been in prison this whole time, you most likely do not have that type of financial backing. And you most likely have been paying fees and lawyer charges and a lot of other stuff that's going to put you in an area where you don't even, you're not even going to be considered to get into the industry. You can work for the industry. Sure. They want you to work for the industry because you were very good at it. I mean, you know, that's the truth, but they don't want you to actually have the business. You know, and that sucks because the other thing is I thought with, you know, seeing all these stores closed down because of COVID, because of the New Jersey vape ban, which wrecked the economy for that side. How many stores? I can't believe we don't even talk about that. But how many storefronts are just empty? You know, those establishments and employees have no jobs. And now with COVID, the unemployment rate is off the wall. So, you know, I was hoping to see small businesses pop up, but what it seems like is they want to make this so strict for the business side of it and for the personal side choice and the recreational user and limit the medical user even further. They want to make the most revenue. And that's not what I want to see. And that's what not a lot of people want to see. I want to see this happen for personal choice. I want to see, you know, communities that have been hit with strong, you know, crime or not crime, but, you know, drug war on drug issues, like where these people have suffered and many of the locals are doing time or sent to jail, like those people, yeah, that should be wiped clean. They should be given the chance to get loans and everything else and start that business. That's what I want to see. I don't want to see chain Wawa, you know, pot stores. That's not what I want to see. I really want to see this do something for everyone. You know, I want to see the local, I want to see the black market industry go away. That's also the other thing. You know, if you make it so strict to the point where, you know, it's governed by big pharma to sell this, you're making the underground market more business than they've ever had because it's going to be so strict and people are not going to be able to get into this industry. And they're going to be like, man, these guys are making bank. Why can't we get on it? You're going to further grow the black market, and the black market's always going to be there, but you're going to make a huge gray area with decriminalization and all these other things you want to put in place. But people will still suffer with that. That's not, you're not, legalization is making it so there is no, you know, there is no penalty for having it. Now, don't get me wrong. If you're distributing black market, you know, man, this is a way where you can end that. You know, if you're letting these people get into, you know, into the industry somehow, and I'm not saying let them just sell on a corner, like actually let them, give them a chance, get them into a storefront, let them, give them the opportunity to get there, and let them pay their taxes and business fees. Like, let those guys strive. Don't make it so only Big Pharma is going to be doing it and they're going to be the ones owning the company and those guys are just going to be working for them or doing black market stuff or more shady things. And that's what we're trying to get away from. You know, treat this like alcohol in the aspect of, you know, people that are allowed to make their own alcohol. I don't even get what the problem is with this. I mean, this is a plant that comes from the ground and you want to say, look, if you're associated with it for cultivation, you're still a felon, but you can buy it legally in New Jersey from our stores. You know, yeah, if you're doing cultivation, yeah, everything you grow should have a tag on it. There are states where people have to file their plants and actually keep up. You know, they have to be smart about it because if, God forbid, their medicine gets out, they should be held accountable. They should be held responsible for their actions. But man, you can't ban it or create gray areas that's now going to like worsen the black market or put people back in prison for something you're making legal. Like, you got to come to some agreement here. And hopefully on Monday when everyone met and a lot of those areas were just not touched, hopefully that's why they're meeting on Thursday, to kind of like loosen it up. And I don't mean loosen it up to make it that it's just like we're going to do whatever the hell we want, because that's not the case. But we really need to like think about this and treat this like alcohol in that aspect for the recreational side and those people, but also think about the medical patients. There's going to be people that are terminally ill and will die most likely before they get their medicine, before they even see a recreational shop that they can even visit. Because right now, dispensaries are so far away and the medicine is so limited and the amounts you can get at certain times is also limited. You know, those people who need that medicine more than me, you know, who more than anybody, and they are, you know, terminally ill, they'll never see that. And this, you know, that's supposed to be, that we're supposed to have better access to it as it is. Like, they haven't done anything for the program whatsoever, you know, to help. I mean, they've let another dispensary open I believe in Monmouth County. But even then, like, you know, it's still it doesn't make it easier for people to get an already expensive, hard to obtain and scarce medicine. That's the bottom line. It, you know, New Jersey is one of the highest states for the medical patient. You know, I myself, you know, struggle with that. I mean, what more, you know, what more do you want from people? You know, you can go to a doctor and get all the prescriptions you want, you know, and go to pain management and milk that system. And, you know, this is a way to give those people life back, you know, that can function. You cannot function if you're drugged like that. You know, there's people that actually have better quality of life and can live out the rest of their life, or, you know, just be comfortable if they're terminally ill just because of cannabis, and they feel a lot better than somebody who's being pumped with a medicine that makes you feel emotionally numb inside. So, you know, why are we not letting this get out there? Why are we not letting this medicine get to more people? Why are we going to make something legal but still keep such a gray area and strict guidelines to everybody so that it's not legal? It's only legal for the state of New Jersey to sell as a business. That's unfair, guys. Anyways, I'm sorry for the rambling. I know it's a lot, but I don't know. Hopefully Thursday something comes to an agreement. Nothing has been signed and nothing's on the governor's desk. So that is a great thing. It's awesome news. And that means there's still hope for everybody, for social justice, for the medical patients, and even the recreational users and the people, man, that just want to get a small business going in this industry that's been here forever. Thanks a lot, guys. Catch you later.